Hello everyone and welcome back to the recipe of the week. My fall break was amazing, amazing, amazing. I heard in my spirit while I was on fall break, because see, when you get rest, you can hear really clear. Repel. So I began looking up the word, and the word repel means to drive or force an attack or attacker back or away. And some synonyms are drive, push, thrust, urge on. I also was reading and it said something about pushing into exile or whatever. So repel or repellent in this instance could very well mean like bug spray, because bug spray like repels and or kills the insect. Well, in our lives, we need to repel the enemy, push him back, get him out of the way. So how do we do that? We repel the enemy by praying, by fasting, by stepping up our faith, reading our word, to know what God says in his word, to know who he is and what he said about you. Somebody say, what he says about you. So the recipe of the week is coming from Psalms 44, 4 through 8, the Message version. And I'm also going to read the concentration scripture, which is verse 5 in the New Living Translations. That's Psalms 44, 4 through 8. And I just learned that the Message Bible is not a version of the Bible. It's just kind of paraphrased. So it's very good to get knowledge and to know and get an eye opener. Okay, let's get into this word. You're my king, oh God. Press pause. So when you know that he's your king and you know that he's your God, you can repel that enemy. Look here, itty bitty devil. You don't have no power. Get back. You're my king, oh God. Command victories for Jacob. With your help, we'll wipe out our enemies. We'll wipe out our enemies with the Lord's help, but only with his help. I'm getting excited because I'm talking fast. Only with his help, in him and through him, Kenny, we wipe out the enemy and keep him back. In your name, we'll stomp them to dust. You can stomp the enemy to dust with the word of God, praying, seeking him, fasting. I don't thrust in weapons. My sword won't save me. In my own space, on my own strength, I cannot push the enemy back. But in him, through him, with him, I can. But it's you, you who saved us from the enemy. It's always him. It's always been the Lord. Always. You made those who hate us lose face. All day we parade God's praise. We thank you by name over and over. So the New Living Translation version says, and the concentration scripture is verse 5, because I was reading the Message version, 44, Psalms 44, 4 through 8. So now I'm reading Psalms 44, verse 5, concentration scripture, repelling the enemy, pushing him back, kicking him out, sending his butt to exile somewhere. Only by your power can we push back our enemies. Only by his power, only in him, through him, can we do it. Not on our own strength. Only in your name can we trample our foes. If I say in the name of Quasanya, ain't nothing happening. Absolutely nothing. In the name of Betty, in the name of Jesse. But baby, when I say in the name of Jesus, step back, get back, Satan. You don't have no power. I already got the victory. The Lord is my king and my savior, my comforter and my keep. Oh, that just made me feel better already. Already. But if you say in your name, it's not working. But if you say in the name of Jesus, you're going to push it back. But we must stay in our word. No longer can we hang on mama them, daddy them, grandma them prayers. Where my mama said that greater is he that's in me. Yes, that is in the Bible, but read it, study it for yourself, because greater is in you. It is, because the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords resides in you and in his strength and by his power. Somebody say, by his power, you can repel, push back, thrust away, send to exile the enemy every single time. I am not saying that he won't come, because sometimes the enemy comes in like a flood, but the Lord will raise a standard against him. And the Bible says no weapon formed against. Listen, the weapon will form, but it won't prosper. That's what you have to remember. Even in your going through your daily walk, things come up against you. Remember, you always have the victory. He said so. Always in him, through him, with him. You can repel, push back, send the enemy flying. Send him flying and on his way. So your word, this is what you need to repel the enemy. This is what you need when you need to get rid of those insects that are around the house. This is what you need to repel. Push back. Know what the word says. Greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. Come on, somebody. When you know that, and it's in your heart, and you're walking in it, and you live by it, you can repel almost anything. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you that you are King. We thank you that in you, through you, and with you, we can repel, push back, sin swinging, sitting singing, send it back to hell, to the pits where it came from, in you and through you. God, we thank you and we honor you, God. And Father, we're sending special prayers out to Israel, your people. God, we know you already got the victory in this. In this, you already got the victory. And God, allow all the kids to be in place and ready for school next week, since it's been fall break. And God, we thank you and we honor you. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Today is Sunday the 8th, and 8, the number 8, always means new beginnings. You're going to get this on Monday, but today is October 8th. So I'm praying that you're stepping into your new beginning, but only in him, through him, and with him. You guys have an amazing, amazing, amazing week. Amazing week. And remember, no weapon formed against you shall ever, ever, ever prosper. You guys have an amazing week. Love you.